It'll be like a composite of all the sculpture and painting I'm doing in India. I'm designing a building that's the size of the Vatican. It's the biggest dome in the world.
Where is this going to
be? Near Calcutta, in India.
That's the south part?
Yeah. It's Mayapur, it's called. It's the holy place. It's a place where Lord Chaitanya was incarnated. In any case, you know about art, you're handling it the right way. If you start like a head, experience. I had these friends who were art touchers, you know, they used like one hair brush.
Yeah.
And so I started a painting, I haven't had it here, but I started a big picture recording, and it was like an idea of how to present an image from sound. And so I started with a big house brush. Now they're used to one brush with one hair in it, you know, and so I started with a house brush. And so I started throwing paint all over the canvas and talking to them without looking. And so I kept thinking, I watched the expression on their faces like going to shock, scared out of their mind. Then I tied it all together, I knew what I was doing. I Then I came down to the final result. It was very refined. I can't even write it off. He started the same way. He gets into massive abstract work and he goes into fine stuff. So what you were just saying is important. If they get the spontaneity of it and rely on the accidents that happen automatically. And so it's a kind of a direction that's coming from higher source.
But you're creating the entire image simultaneously, not one corner from the other. You can see that.
And I, one of the classes I gave here in CC, I taught the college for a couple of years. And so I just broke the fear everybody has about the blank canvas. Just started by demonstration, by taking the thing apart and just by like working spontaneously and you get the feel of it and ultimately all this is done that way, it's all done spontaneously. And so, you know, when you see people doing it, the demonstration helps.
Yeah.
And so if you're doing it yourself, then people can understand how to do it. And they follow.
It's nice when you can put things on the canvas of paper and you can take them away too, but with the watercolor, you can't. Well, what you do is kind of like let it grow up, you know, and then you have to snow and stuff.
Well, like all this, a lot of watercolors here.
Yeah,
I use gouache to make corrections with. If you mix white paint with the color, they can refine it and make changes.
Yeah.
And it's a very easy medium to work with. Then I take a watercolor and I varnish it. And do that in India. And so it turns into an oil painting.
Huh.
All the color enhances.
Sure.
And then I go into oil on top of that and it looks like an oil.
Yeah.
And so it's
that's a big one. Pigments under the brush, sure.
The watercolor dries so quick. And
that makes sense. So is this building going to get built?
Say it again.
You think this building is going to get built, the one in Calcutta, near Calcutta?
Oh, it's being built.
It's being built now?
It is built.
Oh, it is?
It is. Sorry. Then I'll talk about that so much in this program at the library. But now my job is to fill it with art.
Oh.
So there's three levels around the dome with this big, gigantic, huge, and it's massive. But the drum of it is where all the artwork goes, three levels. And it'd be like I've drawn it up already, the major concepts. It's all based on the Srimad Bhagavatamrita, which is a book that tells the whole story how to get from here to heaven by different individuals, Arjuna, Narada Muni, and different personalities that are demigods.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's like very interesting to see how things work in the universe. But all that is described in these books. I mean, that's what drove me to going to India, the philosophy, I mean, the knowledge contained. I mean, the Bible is a little limited. It's been changed so many times, but the Vedic philosophy just practically has no end in it. It's been created by the Supreme Lord himself, and his all his associates that make a contribution. His expansion to give more detail. Basically, when you look through it all, it's like endless. And so because of that, I always thought that, you know, art is such a universal tool that if you take it to its next stage, I was talking to Marty Poole about this, after you learn how to paint and draw, then what do you say? You gotta have a purpose and knowledge and communicate something. You gotta add to the collective nature of the art world itself. So in order to do that, you gotta go spiritual. And so that's what drove me. Immediately I went to India and I started inquiring about these higher things in life. And you gotta find a guru, a person who's all self-realized. And so that's what I did. And after having a close association with this perfected being, and just a normal person, but just connected with God himself directly. So if you follow the pattern of what the great sages and seers give in the way of knowledge, your understanding of like different truths are really self-evident, who we are, why we're here, what's our purpose. And especially for a painter. And you illustrate it and you get answers. I mean, what you see here now is like all the prevalent what I did in India. And so bronzes, sculpture, painted dioramas, laser projections, everything is coming into play. It'll be there. Now I'm afraid India is far away from Corning.
Yeah, I've been. I know.
I tried to get it going here, but the Indian population, a little afraid of their reputation and their jobs at Corning. So it didn't really take place.
It's really remarkable to see your drawings and the interpretation into the bronze.
But I got a lot of students there and people.
Yeah.
When I did this book, I had 50 people working, different artists and artisans were helping in the process.
Mm-hmm.
I'd make the drawings and I'd walk around, we had the whole production line. I had, even my little daughter at 7 years old was helping.
So they'd go from the drawings to clay?
Yeah.
And then cast?
Then cast and plaster.
Plaster and then bronze.
Slipping rubber and then fiberglass.
Fiberglass.
And then paint it look like bronze. These are all.
Oh, I see. I see.
But I have a production line. My daughter, 7 years old, was helping with the detail. There's so much detail in these things.
Yeah.
And so the line progressed all the way around to the guy in the end who was doing the finishing work. And I would just add details and watch and help along the way. So, I mean, Ford, we got to afford it. Is promoting that it was building it. They pumped in $100 million already. And so it's ongoing and now it's just next stage is gonna take a lot of dome projections and just unlimited amounts of artwork.
No, I was a bit younger than he was.
Eric was making movies.
Yeah. So well, he was on TV interviews.
He invited me to a movie shooting.
Not that I knew about.
Larry.
Oh, down there.
I talked with Anna and she said that you'd seen Marlia and I checked the phone books and I didn't find her listed. She apparently has a cell phone. No, I tried when we got back to the area and she had some kind of a block on her phone that you couldn't leave a message and like she was.
Did you make that?
Yep.
Punching the ground.
Yeah, but they have orders. No, that's kind of weird. Let's hope it.
Don't you think so? At this point, they've been going together for like 10 years.
But she said she was okay.
She wants to have kids, that's it.
Yeah, I saw that.
They got two dogs now. They're having a house job.
Now with somebody here, so someday it should be okay.
She wants to have kids.
I haven't seen my family. So I said, well, she's going to be possible.
Well, he's like 53, 54. Chrissy? Chrissy? Yeah? I'm not anymore now. Probably.
Oh, I'm checking out.
He's got to be 50.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know.
Well, I can see where Valerio decided to take him home because he's probably insisted.
Oh, yeah, he's out there.
Yes, and he's the one who associates this from the paper that I've We have, a lot of philosophy and spiritual books that we
What do you think, boys? You know what happened? He explained like the grandpa flood. And this was grandma, this was great grandma's house right here. They put the trains on the bridge. They thought it was a good idea at the time. And of course it was. And everything went down, the coal train from Chandler. Well, we all knew it was going to be like that. We want everybody to
stay.
Don't you have to leave your home? And these guys were babies. A month old. Came up to my house. I made tuna salad, egg salad, I washed all the sheets. We got everybody's memory. I was just trying to have fun.